Hello everyone, I hope you are all well and healthy. Meet me again at PYRO's Cement Techno Channel. On this occasion I will explain about the main burner type for the rotary kiln cement, used in the combustion process in the cement plant. The purpose of the kiln main burner operation is, to form a strong and stable burner flame, so that, 1. Get optimal combustion quality and can produce clinker quality according to the desired standard. 2. Get optimal and stable operation. 3. Formation of a strong and stable coating in the sintering zone. 4. The service life of refractory bricks in the kiln is more durable. Before starting the operation of the kiln main burner, you must know well the type of burner used and how to operate it correctly, according to the standard of operation. First you must identify the burner nozzle, axial and radial primary air ducts, burner nozzle adjustment, fuel lines and burner-related equipment. There are several types of kiln main burners, including as seen in the following pictures and videos. Before we continue this discussion, for those of you who haven't subscribed, please subscribe, like and comment, and watch the video until it's finished, so you can benefit from this video material. Okay, let's move on to the discussion again. Identification of kiln main burners that are widely used in the cement industry, including, as seen in this picture, NFK burner. NFK stands for Nippon Furnace Kogyo, then Rotaflam burner, first generation and second generation Rotaflam, next Novaflam burner, Swirlex burner, and Duoflex burners. Next up, the PYRO-JET burner. There's the PYRO-JET 1, PYRO-JET 2, and PYRO-JET 3, next to the JetFlex burner, Flexiflame burner, and the Unitherm burner. This type of burner is usually for primary air using a roots blower, which has a higher pressure than using a primary fan. Pay close attention, then learn how to operate the type of burner, which we will use for the operation of the kiln. Each type of burner has different characteristics and operating methods. Like the following example. This is an NFK burner configuration, as shown in this picture. The duct holes on the burner tip come from the primary air duct and the coal fuel line. To adjust the shape of the fire by adjusting the valve opening on the axial and radial air ducts from the primary air fan. This is a picture of first generation of Rotaflam burner. It looks like there are axial air, radial air, central air channels, there is a coal fuel line, then there is a scale to change the position of the burner nozzle. Each air line from the primary fan is equipped with a valve to open and close, except for the coal fuel line not having a valve installed. The maximum primary air pressure for the primary fan is around 220 millibar, then we can make modifications by adding roots blower to drain the axial air separately. And the axial primary air pressure can rise to 340 millibars. This is a picture of the second generation of Rotaflam burner, which has a larger capacity than the previous type. And in this picture, there is also an axial auxiliary air duct, because axial's air pressure is only around 178 millibar. Then after setting the burner nozzle and adding an extra fan, the pressure can rise to 206 millibar. This is a picture of the Novaflam burner type, and there are several types of Novaflam produced by this well-known burner company, especially the low NOx burner. This primary air for Novaflam burner uses a fan and roots blower with a pressure between 100 to 800 millibar. Next, this is a Duoflex burner. This type of burner axial and radial air exits through a single channel, as shown in this burner nozzle image. For the operation of this burner, adjust the axial air valve opening 65 to 70% and the radial or swirl air 30 to 35%. The air pressure from the primary and during normal operation is between 200 to 240 millibar. Next, this is the kiln's main burner type, the Swirlex burner. This type of burner cannot change the primary air pressure, because the axial nozzle gap is fixed and can only go forward or backward between 0 to 15 mm, which does not affect the air pressure. For the operation of this burner, adjust the axial air valve opening 65 to 70% and radial or swirl air 30 to 35%. Primary air pressure in normal operation is around 180 millibar. Furthermore, the type of jet flex burner, this type of burner for axial can be changed like a circle shape or can also be rotated like a swirl shape. Radial airways can be retracted as needed. For more details, see the following video. FLS Jet Flex Burner. Jet Flex Burner available in a standard or a plus model. The Jet Flex Burner offers several revolutionary features. The axial jet air nozzles form rectangular-shaped high-speed jets. It enables efficient mixing of hot secondary air to the flame, ensuring fast ignition and stable flame formation. The Jet Flex standard burner is the optimal solution for conventional fuels and high and medium grade alternative fuels. It has no moving parts to maintain, saving operational costs and increasing availability. The combined effectiveness of the Jet Flex burner's air nozzles and swirl has made it possible to eliminate the traditional solid fuel annual channel. In the Jet Flex burner, solid fuels are injected through a straight uninterrupted pipe design. This reduces maintenance and unplanned kiln stops. The common fuel channel can handle all solid fuels. This means less cold air is injected to the kiln, improving the heat economy. Depending on fuel characteristics and the dosing system, the gentler burner can be configured with separate solid fuel pipes. The Gentlex Plus burner enables maximum fuel flexibility by superior combustion of lower grade fuels. It features fully rotatable jet air nozzles and a retractable center pipe. The rotatable jet air nozzles enable the flame to be shaped exactly as required by the fuel and process. The nozzles can also be positioned in a fuel lift configuration, which strongly increases fuel retention time and minimizes fuel dropping out of the flame. The center pipe can be retracted. Combined with the jet nozzles, this allows a significant drop in fuel velocity. This enables early ignition and increases fuel retention time in the flame. The Jet Flex burner's simplified design includes a detachable support beam and reduced overall length, making it fast and cost-effective to deliver and install. Next, this is a PYRO-JET burner. This type of burner for axial and radial air uses a roots blower separately, so it does not affect each other between axial and radial air. This is different from burners that use only one fan for axial and radial air. Primary air pressure reaches 800 bar for axial air and 150 to 250 millibar for radial air or swirl. This type of PYRO-JET burner is slightly different from the previous PYRO-JET, because this type of burner does not use cooling air between the burner casing and the castable burner. Primary air pressure using a roots blower is between 300 to 800 millibar for axial and a radial blower is 150 to 200 millibar. And this is the next type of PYRO-JET burner. The air duct from the blower is simpler. The axial air pressure ranges from 300 to 600 millibar, and the radial or swirl air pressure is 150 to 200 millibar. This type of burner primary air setting uses a speed roots blower setting. The PYRO-JET burner made by KHD. The PYRO-JET system is based on the jet air effect. Conventional and alternative coal and other pulverized fuels are injected through an annular gap. This ensures the most efficient mixture between fuel and secondary air and hence complete combustion. The jet air emerges from the axial nozzles. This creates a strong suction effect and a most efficient mixture between secondary air and fuel. This sandwich flame concept ensures an efficient combustion by saving energy while keeping a stable flame. The swirl air merges from a multitude of slots in the centrally located swirl element, creating a low pressure zone in front of the burner so that already burning particles are recirculated to the base of the flame. The swirl air guarantees a fast ignition and an efficient combustion of the fuel. Due to the adjustable swirl system, alternative fuels are better distributed in the flame core. The spraying position of the swirl element ensures an efficient distribution and therefore complete combustion of the fuel particles. PYRO-JETs are extremely reliable due to their sturdy design. The casting cooling tube is high resistant against heat and dust in case of refractory failure, and it gives extra protection for the burner tip. The fins at the cooling tube increase the heat exchange between cooling air and refractory. Next, FlexiFlame multi-channel burner types for several types of primary fuels and alternative fuels. The primary air pressure is flexible and adjustable between 250 to 500 millibar. This burner manufacturer also manufactures several types of burners for several types of fuel, both for main burners and calciner burners. Furthermore, the MAS unitherm burner, this type of burner is somewhat different from the previous burner type, because it only uses one primary air channel but can be adjusted straight or slightly rotated. MAS or mono air system unitherm burner. The operation of the MAS unitherm burner can be seen in the following pictures and videos. That was the explanation about several types of kiln main burners, and there are many other types of burners used in the combustion process in the kiln system, which we do not show in this video. Thank you for watching this video, hopefully it's useful, and don't forget to subscribe, like and comment, and share it with your friends who need it. See you in the next video.